and focus in on Boeing as well, which I know we get earnings from later this week. But the company's saying this morning it aims to deliver sustainably fueled airplanes by 2030. How realistic is this goal?
I don't think it's not that it's unrealistic. It's that this is a chicken and egg situation. Boeing wants to have planes that can fly 100% on sustainable aviation fuel. The airlines want that. Everybody in the industry wants it, but you don't have the infrastructure that's there right now. Sustainable aviation fuel is 2 to 3 times more expensive than jet fuel right now. And you can't blame the airlines while they want to fly more on sustainable aviation fuel. They're not going to pay 3 times more. That price has to come down. And for that to happen, you're going to need governments to get involved and to say, we need more production of sustainable aviation fuel. Because if that price doesn't come down, they can talk until they're blue in the face. The airlines and Boeing and Airbus, everybody can talk about it. It's got to come down and be price competitive with jet fuel.
Yeah, I mean, it's such a key thing to focus in on, especially when it's not just passenger airlines, but also the cargo players like FedEx and UPS that have put goals out there as well and make up, you know, quite large fleets, too. Phil, travel bans, Delta variant, all the headlines we're getting. What does it do to the airline stocks here?
Look at the airline stocks today, Morgan. They're all up anywhere between 2 and 4% despite this announcement out of the White House. I think everybody knew this was coming. I don't think anybody expected that they were ultimately going to drop the ban on Europeans coming over to the United States as the Delta variant was spreading. I think within the last week, that attitude completely shifted in terms of those who are tracking the industry and within the industry. So I think for the airlines, I mean, they're frustrated. They would like to see Europeans coming to the U.S., but they also realize this is a White House that has said we will not do it until we feel comfortable, and they clearly are not comfortable right now.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.